Welcome back. Here we are on part what, five, six? I've kind of lost count at this point. But we're back at blitztactics.com. We've already got LC back with us. He's ready to enjoy some puzzles. Hopefully, I won't flounder too badly this time, but that's what I keep saying every time. And there's still a lot of floundering. So, without too much ado, let's get this on the road. I do find it funny. Level 38. You would think that after the first 37 levels, these puzzles would start with things that aren't checkmate in one, but queen takes h7 is just mate, so anyway. I'm not sure where the nuance is in some of these. Are these all mate in one puzzles? No, that's not a mate in one. That just wins material, this wins a queen. Or more? Oh, and there's mate. These puzzles are unforgiving. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Catch a tiger by the toe. If he hollers. Oh, there we go. Found it. This one's the rook. This wins lots of stuff. It's gonna take the rook, and then I saw the mate. Mate in three. This website sure loves its checkmates. Where's the mate here? What's bothering me about this is that the queen defends the rook, right? So, I mean, I could keep trying to approach with my queen. I guess approaching with the queen and then rook a4 is mate. Not the simplest puzzle ever. But it works. It definitely functions as a puzzle. This wins a bishop. If I could just put the queen on the square. And let's take that. Okay. That wasn't so hard. Understanding endgame, I kind of wish that that was a bigger thing on chess sites. Oh, hey, look, free knight. Okay. Well, king d7 wins, but this is more accurate or more forcing. At least I'm pretty sure king d7 wins. Checkmate. Checkmate. I mouse slipped. Thought I put it on a5 or something. Oh, queen a4 is not mate because he goes to d5. What am I thinking? Okay. Let's take the free knight because they've got check threats. Except why do that when you can just win the house? Okay, what's the nuance here? Okay. Yeah, that hidden rook in the corner is pretty nasty. I guarantee people will not see that sort of thing in Blitz games. I can pretty much guarantee that. Now, computers, on the other hand, will have no problem spotting that, but people will struggle. So we've seen all the puzzles once for level 38. Prepare to see them a few more times until I manage to get through this without blundering. Check, checkmate. Check, 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 checkmate. Free pawn, take a queen. That wasn't so bad, now was it? Mate in one, mate in two. This one's kind of tricky. Okay, and mate in two there. This involves kicking the queen and then taking the free knight. And we're on to level 39. All right, here we go. Check. Oh, I was trying to scheme how to win the rook there. Didn't quite work out. That's free stuff, though. Check. Where's the mate? Oh, there it is. Bishop e5. Well, that's pretty tricky. All right. Oh, I've seen this one before. What's with this game recycling puzzles? It expects me to remember them or something. Free rook. Free knight. That's all there was there. I'll have to take it. No, I can't take it. I can block here. That was weird. I rejected alternatives by process of elimination, but okay. Yeah, I guess I didn't see that mate in three. What do I do here? Okay, mate in two, three, something. Four. Well, important thing is that I found the mate. Not that I counted it properly, because I totally did not. There we go. Take one of those, one of those, one of these. There we go. Hey, look, we get the same puzzle twice in a row. Like I've been saying, the site does. And saying that, you know, sometime I should muster up the energy and motivation to do my own version of this site, because the authors obviously, they're slow. They're really slow in releasing their source code. So if I want to get anything done, I've got to do it myself. Regretfully. Eight and two. Eight and one. Mate and nothing. Free rook. Mate. Not a mate. There we go. Bishop g6. Oh, those moves are all forced. I get it. And so now on to level 40. Okay. Idea chess. Well, I'll take a look at it. I'll definitely take a look at it. Hopefully, I'll get through this puzzle set today. Better things. Oops, that drops a queen. We have to play the pawn forward. That's the reason the pawn was there. I've seen this puzzle before. There's a ton of recycled puzzles. Okay, free stuff is free. Really? Promotion doesn't work. What's the deal? Why these moves? Let me check. Okay. Let me check again. Is that Zugzwang or something? I don't get it. I don't get this one either. Yeah, I'll have to take a look at this idea chess thing. I'll bookmark that. So what's going on here? Oh, right. Smashing. Okay, let's take one of those. Or I'm in check. I have to block the check. I have to do something about this check. There, let's not block it. Let's just take the free piece and then do the mate in one. And I got nothing. I mean, I could take there. That's bad. Does this win stuff? Yeah, that wins stuff. Winning stuff is cool. Alright. Free queen. Okay, that was just a guess out of desperation. Queen h6, maybe? I mean, how's he gonna stop the mate on h7? The back rank is covered, so I don't need to worry about this. Okay. Check is not saving me. How do I save my butt here? My butt's in big trouble. Oh, queen f here. Queen f8. That's a nice tactic. Okay, swings the rook. This just mates outright. No, not that way. Okay, queen e7 fails. Oh, because there's mate on b2. Right. Rook g8 fails. Oh, I just need to invert the move order. I knew it. Alright, this mates. This is the queen f8 thing. This is mate in one. This is the puzzle we just looked at. This is rook f1, just winning material. This is bishop b8, interfering with the rook's defense of a8. It's mate in one. Some dumb pawn takes thing that I don't understand. Winning the rook. Whoops. Queen h6. Take the queen. Take the rook. Mate. Checkmate. Check. Threaten mate. And deliver mate. Mate and one. I've seen this puzzle before so many times. And this Legall's mate. Rook is not defended. Sack the queen, because why not? Oh, crap. Sack the rook. I have a check, so take the checking piece. And we're on to the next level. Whew. Well, that was fun. Yeah, I think keeping on the scoreboard is just going to be a matter of who's available to solve the problem sets as the problem sets are delivered. And users can contribute problem sets, or levels, I guess they're called. Okay, rook f1. Rook f1 wins material. No, he's got g5. This wins material, though. Smates. So, I think just staying on the scoreboard is a matter of just solving the levels the instant they're released. And really the way to do that would be the person who's making the levels. Okay, so rook c to c4 threatens rook h4, followed by rook takes knight mate. There's better here. Oh right, because rook c4, he's got rook d1. That's a problem. So yeah, we just do bishop f1. Just give mate in one, you know? It's a pretty silly puzzle. Okay, where's How do all the stereotypical moves not work there? That's how. Just have to find a way to coordinate those pieces. Free rook. I might have played moves like that in my over the board games. All right, c6 is hanging. It's just a mate. Okay. Just do one of the checks. It's got to be one of them. Why would he go there? That's just dumb. Why not f8? Oh, because there's mate in one. I get it now. Okay. Fancy stuff. Oh. I'm surprised that that move was best. Like, the instant I released it, I regretted the move. I've seen this puzzle before, and I don't remember it. Alright. Okay. Oh, that's mate. Okay, rook d6 wins a queen for a rook. I mean, it's got to, but. Oh, this is, must be better. Free stuff. Okay, here we hit the queen, which can no longer defend the knight. Standard sack, sack mate. Just here win the rook. Here, bishop f1 is mate. Rook there. And mate. Skewer. Take the knight first and then take the queen. I think the point there in that puzzle was that my knight was attacked. Or my queen was under attack from the knight. Rather. Oh, I get it. So yeah, queen e8 in that last puzzle would not have been good. On account of queen takes queen. Two. This is the one we started with. Four. This is a nice little mating pattern. I also appreciate that the puzzle doesn't fail me for alternate solutions. Alright, so we're on to level 42. Let me refresh the scoreboard. It's another gripe I've got here is that there's no way I can get that to automatically refresh. But I'm on my way to the top. Mate in one. Not a mate in one. Oh, nice. Not a mate in one. Mate in one. Free stuff? No. Why does that not work? Rook takes knight, rook takes queen, rook takes queen. I'm threatening mate. He's got to play rook d8, and I've got a rook and a knight versus a rook. I could win that. Why go through that trouble when you can just checkmate in three moves? Seen this tactic before. I forget if I've even employed that in my own games. Maybe. It sure likes the h-file checkmate too. That one tends to crop up quite a bit. Okay, why is queen d8? Well, I guess he's got king f7. Queen e7's not it. Really trying to just get absorbed in the moment here. Oh, duh. I've got two pieces attacking this pawn right next to the king, so that's just mate in one. Spotting mate in one is a useful skill. I released the queen, and then I saw the knight was hitting b7. So already we see that I'm kind of exhausted, kind of distracted. Oh well. Does rook e1 win material somehow? Probably. When's an exchange? Exchange is good. Nope. Because queen takes rook is a check. Okay, my initial guess of queen f6, which I rejected because I didn't see rook takes rook, was actually correct. Alright, mate in 3. These are actually starting to get a bit more challenging. I do appreciate that. Free stuff. Free stuff. Check, check, mate. Double check. No, this double check and just take the queen. I guess I'm not mating, so I should just win material. Wait, how is knight e6 not the right? Oh, rook f7 is mate. Knight e6 looked forcing, and I had an abundance of checks to follow. But, you know, just winning on the spot is good enough too. Rook e1. Again, here we just win material. Check. Check. This check. That check. Here a check, there a check. Everywhere a check, check. Old MacDonald had a check. EIEI, check, oh, check, check, check. By the way, check just means king. So when people like Chess Wiz say check to your king, they're being facetious. Hopefully. Oh, that's mate because the knight's pinned. I missed that the first time around and wondered why he didn't just do knight takes knight. Check, 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 mate. I'm in check. Hit the rook, take the knight. Mate in 3. Another mate in 3. Mate in 1. Just win material. Mate in 3. Mate in 1. And we're on to the next set. Update the leaderboard. Here we go. Free queen. Take one of those. What's that rook and knight mate called, by the way? I've forgotten. It's got some fun name. Free queen. So much free stuff. Oh, what's one move slower? That's actually much less effective. So, it's for once, it's right to judge my solution as being wrong. I don't know what's going on here. Oh, apparently I've just got a mate in one. You know, if I just, that's not mate in one. Is this mate in one? Yeah. What? Okay, just take the queen. Mate in 3, not a mate. I keep declaring checkmate when it's not, just to make this more fun. Well, okay. I guess that works. I'm not sure why the other way didn't work. Mate in 4. Check. Oh, come on. Oh, mate there. Did not see the bishop lurking on d3. It'd be one thing if I had any time at all to appreciate where the pieces were before I started moving. But where's the fun in that? Okay. Oh, there's the mate. That's clever. Okay, just pin the queen. I don't even need to take it. Like, why is the puzzle forcing me to take it? Does this mate? Nope. That doesn't mate. Okay, well, something special is called for here. I'm not sure what. Like, I'd be extremely tempted just to play bishop c3 and call it a day. Is that the move? It totally should be the move. There should be a set of puzzles which takes this and flips the concept on its head. Instead of making it about attacking, make it about defending in blitz chess. And just come up with the move that delays the checkmate just long enough. So, I mean, you could be sacking all of your pieces. It could be beautiful. But just make enough of a fortress that it aggravates your opponent or confuses them long enough that they can't mate before their clock expires. I mean, that's the ultimate troll chess right there. Okay, see, I just win a piece on the h-file. Yeah. By the way, thanks for the advice on that one, because I was actually kind of struggling with it. I don't know why I have to take the queen in that. It seems pretty obvious that the queen's not going anywhere. Wait, where do I go here? I just take the rook. No, I just mate. That one's gonna challenge me a bit. This mates. This mates-ish. I'm not sure why he doesn't play king f6 in that position where I sack the rook. Alright. Win the queen. Line up for a mate. Mate and one. Not a mate. Win the rook. I mean, I understand in some positions where queen takes rook in the corner might not be entirely obvious. And the game wants to just make sure that you saw the capture. I guess that's the same concept where the queen's pinned, but generally you don't pin the queen and then be like, oh, now I see that the queen is pinned. I mean, you couldn't mess that up even if you wanted to, because the queen cannot step out of the pin. Just take it at your leisure. Okay, so take one of these. Take one of those. Om nom nom. And we're on to level 44. Let's refresh the leaderboard. Oops. There we go. Yeah. Well, you know, after the first 42, you start to get the hang of it. That, and I've been playing a lot of blitz and bullet chess, just ever since chess was invented. I was about to do queen e5, and I realized that queen e5 would lose a queen. Oh, gotta take that. Very tricky. But yeah, see, that's the sort of thing I was talking about, where you could just flip this whole concept on its head and see, like, if you could come up with some tricky moves to just try to keep the game alive a little bit longer. Really perfect the art of trolling opponents. I have a sense that if I developed such a thing, people would hate me for it. Although the game itself would be pretty cool. Oh, that's mate, because the rook's on d1, not on c1. Queen takes rook is not mate, but it's pretty darn good. Oh, f6 does mate. Is this queen trapped? This queen is trapped. check. It's not mate. Is this mate? Is this mate? Is this mate? Is that mate? There we go. Found it. But yeah, when there's such limited material attacking the king, there's only so many possibilities. Apparently none of them work this time, though. So what's up with that? I tried rook c7's obvious. Bishop e3, it's gotta be bishop e3. But that was the first thing I tried. I must have mouse slipped it. That's a shame. Oh, I was gonna take the rook en passant there. Turns out that's not how rooks can be taken. I saw that one in a previous puzzle set. Is this mate? 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 Yeah, I found it. 5 tries. Up g5. There we go. Free rook. Mate in 1. Okay, this one that stumped us so badly because I didn't really think the rook in the corner would contribute. Alright. Oh, right, I have to do the in-between move, the Zwischenzug. I need to play these Zwischenzugs. But they're kind of important, especially in fast games. Why are they so important in bullet? Because opponents fall for combinations where it's pretty common just to forget that Zwischenzugs are possible. So that's why they tend to be super effective in bullet and blitz. Okay. I was stumped why that puzzle forced me to play. Hang on. Why it forced me to bring my queen back to d5. Also, forgive me if I'm not immediately replying to people as they speak in chat. That wins the queen, and a bit more. That's mate. Check, 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 mate. Have to do the Zwischenzug. I'm pretty sure that once I've played, well, I guess part of the reason it makes you play out the whole combination is that sometimes the last move does matter. And it's not entirely obvious. Yeah, the point is to help you recognize the patterns, maybe. Maybe part of the point is that it's just fun. And gives you a sense of progression. Or maybe there is no point. Okay, mate in 3, 4, something like that. I don't get this one. I'm really confused. So I've got rook a6. I've got rook c... No, rook c7's out. The first thing I considered was rook c8, and I didn't see that this rook was on c1. That rook on c1 changes everything. I did not look all the way back to the c1 square. Oh, I'm pinned. So we'll just use the queen instead. Free stuff. Free stuff. Oh, mate. Don't take the rook when there's a mate. Free queen. Oh, come on. I could win that. Alright, so... it's gonna force me to calculate... Don't you all love calculating endgames? So king d6 or king d7, king e6, rook g6. Okay, it is fast enough. Yeah, I'm gonna pull that kind of nonsense in my games. You know me. Just throwing all caution to the wind. Oh, come on, really? Okay, so I have to take that. Let me promote. And we get a trivial not endgame. Okay. Yeah, this mating threat is powerful stuff. I've actually seen that puzzle before. Is that cheating? Oh, free rook. Okay. I think that's called Bowden's mate. Right. I'm not sure what this pattern's called. Also, sometimes you'll see me move the queen or the rook all the way across the board, and then move it sharply back to capture a piece that just interposed. Just because I didn't anticipate some of the interpositions. I don't get this one either. Oh, wait. Take all the stuff, maybe? Okay, let's just take the queen. Simple. Wait, why did he go up? Going up did not seem very bright. Perhaps it was forced. Check. Check. Rook takes looks a bit... Oh, I get it. Okay. Sorry, I was thinking about the last puzzle. Rook takes is kind of strong in the last... Or is the best in the last puzzle. Because the alternative brings you into an endgame that's just horrific. Mate in 3. Alright, let's check. Again, I'm not sure why you just block on e5, but there's got to be some tactic. Okay, win a tempo on the rook. You could actually try to pin the pawn, although it doesn't matter. Mate on c8. Win the queen. Mate in 3. This mate again. Check, check, mate. Just take the queen and win the knight. Mate in 2. Take the queen. I'm surprised he doesn't play king g7 at some point in that sequence. It would just put up a little bit more resistance. Okay. Or at least optically so. I wonder if there's a cooler way to give checkmate there. Alright, we made it up to level 46. Let's indicate that on the scoreboard and continue onward. I mean, my blitz and bullet ranking varies by sight. On the leaderboard, my name here is Toad of Sky, or Todovsky, and I use that same name on Lee Chess. So, depending on whether I'm playing blindfolded hyper bullet or just normal bullet, my ratings differ. Plus, I mean, Lee Chess ratings are in flux anyways, so whatever. But I mean, I think I'm decently good. Correct me if I'm wrong. If I'm just bad at chess, let me know. Because I mean, some days I'm pretty bad. But I'm okay at these tactic things. Oh, here's the mate. That's a fun one. Mate in 1. Not a mate in 1. Also not a mate in one. Definitely not a mate in one. Okay. This queen. Oh, I get it. Queen's defending the rook. I don't know why I have so much difficulty spotting some mate in ones. It's funny that I miss those. Oh, here's a one. That one's cool. It's officially got cool status in my book of mate in ones. Okay. There we go. That's a lot of checks. Free queen. That's a pretty well-known opening trap. Particularly if you've fallen for it, you tend to know it a lot better. Check. Oh, okay. I thought there was going to be something better there. Right. So go for the mate. Okay, so we stack the rook so we can get the other rook involved. Check. Is this actually mate? There's the mate. I'm not good at. Well, I don't know. My effectiveness varies. Where's the idea here? I mean, c7 is a target, b6 is a target, so just hit both targets, and you win a queen. Okay. I'm not sure why Black did it that way. That looked pretty straightforward. Okay, what's going on here? I see I can't do Queen A7, but you would think that B7 or C6. Oh, right, just take the darn pawn. It seems silly that opponents would just hang stuff, but they do. And so you have to be prepared for that as well. There's the mate in six. Here's just winning a queen. Here, my queen's under attack, so we hang it as many times as possible. Here we take the free pawn and mate. Here we have to check with the bishop to deflect the king. That's a rook sack to get at this knight over there. Silly mate in one. Typical mate in three. Not sure. Not sure. Oh, bishop takes is strong because queen takes is the follow-up. I'm not sure I get that. Alright, queen takes queen is a mate in one. A mate in one is more effective than a mate in two. Check, 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 not a check. Check, check, not a check, check, check. Oh, hang on, I goofed that up. I was having too much fun singing. Check, 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 check. 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 Not a check. Check, 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 Check. Check, check, check. Always check, it might be mate. Not a check. Check, 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 check. Not a check. Check, not a check. Hey, we made it to the next level. Yeah, I have streamed blindfolded Hyperbolic before. Mostly consists of me pre-moving things or attempting to on an empty board, and trying not to get frustrated when I lose on time. .960 blindfolded might be a bit tricky because you don't get to see the starting position. .960 blindfolded any time control would be pretty tricky. I'm not sure how you'd get the hang of it. You'd have to like make some pawn moves and rely on your opponent telling you what piece is where. So that could be kind of a disaster. Okay. 8 and 4. I don't see the mate here. Just take a rook. Okay, where's the mate? Oh, mate in 1. I'll take that. Not a mate in 1. Oh, it's gonna do knight takes rook, and he just sacked his queen. Wait, do I have... Okay, that fails because queen f5 mates on the spot. Oh, right. I've seen that one before. Well, that tends to be convincing, except that rook's on the back rank. So we have to go for mate instead. I was so prepared to give queen b7 checkmate, and then the computer just decided it was gonna sack a piece to delay the mate. It's a nice little tactic. Ooh. I don't like this one. I guess that's a trapped queen. I'm not sure how I spotted that before my time expired. That's a trapped king, for sure. Okay. Free rook. Take the bishop. Mate in 1. Check. Check. Mate. Take a queen. Ooh. Threaten mate. Take free stuff. Take free stuff. And mate. Win as much material as possible. Double check. Mate. Free rook. Deliver mate. Mate in 1. Rook e1. Rook e7. Take this. Free stuff. And we're on to level 48. Wow, that one wasn't so hard. Alright, let's... And blindfolded games are difficult for those who haven't tried and for those who have tried them. Okay. Oh, my king is under pretty heavy fire, so I actually am forced to check here. I didn't see queen h6 check at first. This is a good tactic to know. If you're going to know, like, one fancy tactic, know that one. It's deflection. Okay. I mean, that one seemed pretty obvious. I'm not sure why black fell for it. Okay. Okay. I saw that that wasn't mate, and that's why I hesitated. Wait, we gotta take here. And then take the knight. Oh, is pinning the queen not good enough? Do I have to actually checkmate him? I suppose if I have to checkmate him, I will. So, threaten mate. Threaten mate. Take stuff. Check, check. And don't take the rook. Oh, I've got a. How is that a white rook on A8? No, seriously, how did that happen? Okay, where's my mate in one? Queen G7 mates in one. I didn't see that. I feel a bit embarrassed. Hey, free bishop. Free stuff. Have to take there because there's nothing better. Not sure why that last check mattered. I was just stalling for time, really. Oh, well, that's fancy. It's a crisscross mate. Check, 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 mate. Promote to a queen. Mate on G7. H file mate. Double check and mate. There's another fancy mate. Okay. You gotta just take stuff. Due to the threat on G7, Black's forced to play Bishop F6 there. Check, 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 check. And it's not mate, but it's good enough. Win a rook for a knight. Win two rooks for a queen. Not sure why Rook F7 is necessary. Possibly it is not. Hang on. Almost got me there. Almost got me. That's a good deflection tactic. Nice. 48 levels down. However many is 65 minus 49 plus one to go. Yeah, we'll see if we get to 65. Okay. It's a nice variation on the same theme. Free bishop with check. Oh, I was so ready to give queen b7 mate. I was so ready. Oh, that's not mate. That queen's actually defended. Guys, Black's heard of this thing called defending your pieces. It might get a little more tricky from now on, because he doesn't just hang stuff randomly. Okay, that was a mouse slip. Okay, now this is a brain fart. So I wouldn't have gotten it anyway, whatever. Am I trapping a queen? What's the big idea here? Oh, he's got knight takes e5 in the retaliation. So, yeah. This one's not so obvious. Man, it's almost gonna make me regret inventing chess. Okay. Well. Is knight h4 trapping the queen? Because that would just be ridiculous. It is, isn't it? Yeah. Now that's just dumb. I mean, there's some tactics which are fun just because they're so outlandish like that. there's no practical value to, oh, here's, oh, come on. Bishop b1 and queen g6 is beautiful. The computer has no aesthetic sense. Sigh. Oh. You know why? I mean, bishop b1 followed by queen g6 threatens this stuff, but, you know, just... Yeah. I'm always finding the hard way to do things. And yet, it reminds me of some other players who claim, and rightly so, that they always find the hard way to do things. They make an art of finding the most challenging and interesting way to solve a position. Okay, wait. Oh, come on. Knight. Oh, it's not a forced mate in 2, because it's just king takes a3. Alright, so I have to go up here and mate in the corner. Well, it looks kind of cute. Alright. I mean, that pins the rook. Threatens. It doesn't lose this idea of me taking f4, which I spotted after I traded rooks. I spotted rook takes rook, getting rid of the attack on the queen, threatening d8, giving me some time to figure out, like, what I should be attacking. I should just take here first. Apparently. I'm not sure how to follow it all up. I was just guessing. I'm gonna check. I have to get out of check. Playing your legal moves scores you points. Check. Nice. Wait. Knight f7 does not work. Oh, am I supposed to trade here? You know, insert the rook trade, just because it makes the endgame better. Okay, and then we win the queen. We got a mate in 1. Got, oh, that was a mate in 1. Alright, we win the queen here. Trap a queen. This entire set's just about queens, isn't it? Ah, okay, I get it. This just wins a queen outright, and you have to get out of check. That one's not about a queen. This, we threaten f7, and somehow black just resigns that for some reason. Here we do the obvious thing, and not the thing I spotted. This prolongs the mate the longest, but that just traps the queen. This deflects the rook so you can win the queen. This wins the bishop with check. And then, oh, I get it. You trade the rooks so you can win the queen. Otherwise, you just do rook takes. That's cheeky or clever or something. It's resourceful. That's the word. On to level 50. Are you guys ready? You don't have to do this all again to get 65, right? I don't know. We'll see. Oh man, I've been going for almost an hour. Let's get through 50, and then reconsider what we're doing with our lives. I seem to be on somewhat of a roll here. Just promote. Easy endgames are easy. Get as many pieces involved in the checkmate or this net as possible. Ooh. So, yeah. To interfere with the rook. Ooh. What's the deal here? I'm afraid I don't get this. My rook's loose. I could retreat to h3 with the bishop and you just place f5. Do I have some intermezzo? Like, bishop g5 threatens mate. Oh, just win more material and take the bishop. Whatever. Intermezzo. That's another good cheapo to know. That little fork. He has to block with the queen or else he gets pinned. Check. Mate. Free queen. Oh, that's not a free queen. Just take here, though. Check. Mate. Check. Check. Mate. Oh, hang on. I'm gonna pin. I have to do something about that pinning piece. There we go. You know, I'm really confused by this one. I don't get it. Usually you can just get away with some mate threat nonsense that takes priority over everything. I guess rook d8 is that mate threat nonsense in this case. Yeah. Check the variations for yourselves, but that rook d8 forces mate. I'm in check. Let's get out of check. Let's get out of check again. Well, that was mate in one. I thought that would be more tricky. Or challenging, or whatever word is appropriate here. D5. Oh, we just take the rook and mate on the back rank and fork to deflect. Check and mate. Rook d8. And if queen takes queen, everything's all ruined there. Namely, his defense of various squares is busted. Here, you can just push the pawn through due to threats on the knight. This is mate on the a-file. This is an intermezzo, just winning a piece. This is... okay. Queen there is wrong because I need my bishop attacking. So, prepare for another tour through these glorious, glorious puzzles. Yeah. Wait, mate in one. Mate in one takes priority. Check mate in two if I can just get the knight onto the right square. Mate in one. Mate in three. Rook d8. Check mate there. Take all the stuff. Check. Oh, that's the key. I didn't initially see that promotion was also check. So I did have some unresolved concerns the first time I solved it. But through consecutive solves, I see more and more each time about the position. This can actually take some time to look at it in the fleeting instance before the next puzzle gets loaded. Oh, right. That check was not the right answer. Always check it might be mate, except don't check when checking is bad. One, check, take here. I'm I was so ready to follow up with rook takes bishop. It was just right there. Just tuck the king in the corner, because why not? Intermezzo, free bishop. Right, bishop e6 is necessary. Win the queen. Almost there. We're almost there. Man, do I have to go through all the puzzles to get to the next level? There we go. 50 levels down. Should we do another one? Missed mate in 11 in a live game. Ouch. How did you miss that? I'm just kidding. I would have missed it. I've been on the receiving ends of some pretty colossal mating attacks in over the board games. So I totally understand how things like that go missed. Whoa. Okay, so then we protect the pawn, and then protect the promotion square, and then take a queen, and then proceed to checkmate. I'm surprised it forced me to play that through to the end. Okay. Is this the part where it questions me about my ability to finish combinations? Because, whoa. Okay, now that was the right move. I mean, I think if I see the key move, I can probably find the follow-up. Just saying. Still, I guess, not all the puzzles, or not all the levels are going to be the same. So, some will, I guess, force you to play it out to the end. Oh, free queen. Okay, free knight. Free king? Not entirely a free king. A nice mate in four pattern. Every tournament chess player needs to learn that one. Okay, that was a bit tricky. You saw me hesitate as I played through it. I don't just hesitate for a dramatic effect, by the way. I hesitate because some of these are actually challenging. Okay, like that one. That one's challenging. I mean, gosh, there's like 10 candidate moves here, at least. Things like knight f5 and knight h5 are also up for consideration. Queen d3 is too, but I didn't see the point. But given that I passed on it and that I failed the problem, it's probably queen d3. Queen d3, king g5, and what? Like, rook f5? Is that the idea? Rook f5, queen f5. Okay, it was good enough. Okay. Oh, free rook? No, just checkmate. Why take pieces when you can checkmate? Okay, this one's... Am I trapping a queen? Yeah, I'm trapping a queen there. So say there's nothing going on in that position, except for maybe winning a queen. Which is just a really funny and absurd way of looking at chess. It's just saying, well, there's absolutely nothing going on here, other than something that immediately decides the entire game. You know, other than that, just nothing. Just don't worry about it. Take advantage of this pin to win the queen. Make sure we don't drop our own queen. Take that queen. Smothered mate. Alright. Queen trap. Oh, king. Ah, darn it. I saw queen e7. I really did. And yet, I see this awesome pattern. Like, the patterns will stay with you. Some of these silly things that crop up once in 100 games, those might not stay with you. I don't think I saw that problem before. That was weird. Oh, my mouse slipped. I mouse slipped with rook c6. Even though I was clearly aiming for d6. On that last move, I was looking for a more efficient way to move my cursor to solve the problem, and did not come upon one. Okay, queen d1 is the right answer here. We deflect the queen away from defending the rook. Decoy the king and a g8. Deflect the rook away from that defense. Trap the queen. Check, 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 mate. Hit the queen again. Check, check. This is mate. Oh, there's another mate in that final position. I did not see that. But you could just move the queen to checkmate. Free queen. And we're on to level 52. Very nice. You need help. Tomorrow you have a chess contest. Help. I would recommend, I mean, there's nothing you can do to cram to prepare for it in the last day. There's absolutely no way. Just can't be done. So, I would recommend just getting some rest, getting a good night's sleep and such, and whatever. Yeah, no, you're absolutely right that there's an exploit on the site, but whatever. That did occur to me a while ago, but where's the fun in that? Where's your honor? Yeah, I know that that's possible. Believe me, as a person who regularly exploits bugs, that one definitely came to mind. Alright, free queen. But no, I'm playing this out because I actually kind of enjoy it. Free queen. Yeah. Alright. Castle? I mean, what am I supposed to... Oh, free stuff. There's the free stuff. I found it. Okay, bishop h7 is the pattern. Doesn't work here. Queen h7 is another pattern. Doesn't work here. Do I have to take the rook knight? Is that what's called for? Does that make all the patterns work? Or do I do bishop g6? Bishop g6 looks crushing. Just optically, but I think there's queen f7 in some lines and doesn't quite cut it. Or I could just take the free rook. Which apparently is winning and or checkmate. So apparently that's a thing. Okay. Simple, 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 simple. There we go. Yeah, I see all the advanced stuff. Oh, hang on. That's mate. If I can just move the knight to g5. Okay, decoy the king. Decoy. Wait. Oh. Yeah, I find the longer combination, which involves the shorter move. Wait, I should just take this and checkmate. Just go for the more forcing combination. Go for the throat. Queen c3. Interesting. Oh. Oh, maybe he's fixed the bug. Good for him. Is this mate? Is this mate? Is this mate? Yay! Checkmates. Okay. Oh, that's a fun little tactic. I want to take en passant. This is stronger. Maybe hit that and take the bishop. And just move the bishop out of harm's way. Rook c7 looked, I don't know, it's probably what I would play in a blitz game. What do I have that's better? I suppose there's this, just winning everything. I guess that's a slight improvement. Forced mate. Bishop takes. Wait, what? Okay. Mate and four. Found it. Check. 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 Mate. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Free queen. All the free stuff. Hang on. Let's take there. Oh, right. This is one of the first ones I encountered. Just took me a minute to recall it. Then you do pawn takes queen at the end of that variation and make black suffer. For not having resigned. Hit the rook, hit the bishop. Oh, right. Check, 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 mate. Yes, there are forcing combinations. Or, I'm sorry, there are moves which probably win, which don't involve checks. That's not what the puzzle's looking for. Wait. Knight f6 wins. That should not be rejected. I mean, yeah, this wins faster, but knight f6 does win. But whatever. I'm not the one who designed this site. Who am I to judge? Check. Wait, what am I doing here? Threatening mate, winning a queen, promoting to another queen, and taking it on pre-queen, taking a free bishop. Oh, taking in d5. These sideways moves flummox players of all skill levels. Alright. Alright, the king is trapped. Long live the king. In the words of Scar. Oh, right, just take the rook. Taking free stuff is not occurring to me today, apparently. It was earlier, and now it's not as much. So I either need to. Okay, that one occurred to me. Taking the queen. This one taking the pawn. I see these beautiful combinations that all follow patterns and motifs and other themes. But spotting the just take a piece in one move is not always obvious. Check, check. Yeah, I kept looking for a way to improve upon that too, because it'd be nice to play out these variations faster somehow. Oh, I'm gonna check. This is check. This is check. Wait. Always check, it might be made. I like this queen sack. Again, it follows patterns. Oh crap, what was it here? Not queen. Oh right, it's just take the rook. That one's gonna kill me every time. I need to just get better at taking the rook. Or I need to solve this level before I get to that problem. Which it is possible to do. You don't have to solve all the problems. Game does kind of take some mercy on you if you do manage to solve enough problems quickly enough. But yeah, taking the rook is a useful skill. It's just that's super uncommon. Not only for a queen to be attacking the rook there. Also, sorry, I'm distracted. Not only for the queen to be attacking the rook, but also for it to be on pre, on the back rank on e8, and for that to be the strongest move on the board. I mean, if you've got an on pre rook on that square, you've got some things that are wrong with your position. Free bishop. Check, checkmate. And we advance without having to get through that puzzle another time. All right, refresh the leaderboard. Let's do it. Let's go, go, go. That was a good start. Checkmate. Put him in the queen. Yeah, there's no mate, so just take the queen. Oh, hang on. Mate in four. Check. Forced mate. Ooh, this one's nasty. We have to seal the king off, crazy house style. There we go. Mate. Nice. Okay. Yeah, sure, make me play it out to mate. Find these awesome forcing moves, but I guess it's possible somebody might blunder upon that combination. Seems unlikely. I mean, I got this check, I've got Queen H5 check. I think I just slipped on trying to get the Queen to H5. Pretty sure Queen H5 was good enough. Dude, where's my mate? There it is. Free queen. Free stuff. Free king. Oh, wait. There we go. Check. 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 Mate. Oh, darn it. No. Okay, I get it. That was tricky. This one's tricky too. So Black's got Queen B6 if I don't check him. So I'm pretty sure, pretty darn sure that checks. I mean, yeah, I could move the rook away or something, but checks are going to be part of this answer. Unless something pretty spectacular happens. This one's tricky, for sure. So, I don't know, maybe I take it? Then what? I mean, oh, okay, that's not so obvious. Free knight, free knight, free pawn, free knight this way. I don't see the difference, really. Is this mate? That's a nice little puzzle. Free stuff. Win material. Oh, win material that way. That's the key. Okay, these are actually getting more challenging. Okay, free bishop, free knight. Take here, check like this, and then take the queen. Oh, and okay, I get it. The point there is that I'm also winning the knight. So I'm winning as much material as possible. There's my mate. That mate's messy. Took me a minute to remember why that was winning. This one's the queen. This would just trap the king. Knight b6 forces mate. Oh shoot, I forgot about this. That's important. I did see it the first time. But on repetition, I forgot about our nuances. So around and around and around we go. Where we stop, we'll find out. I don't know yet, but as long as I keep making progress, we'll just keep going, blasting through these. I'm not sure why one way was better than the other. Oh, Queen G7's the mate. Wins the rook. Check. At least I think this wins the knight at the end. This is a forced mate. Rook takes rook. This check. Alright. Oh, this, we do rook takes because we need another attacker. We just win the queen here. Crisscross mate of sorts, not really. Check, check, and just go around and mate. Okay, now since there's the mate. And we're on to level 54. Well, one level after another. We're ranking our way up the leaderboard. How are we doing? So, made it into 6th place. If I make it up 2 more levels, I'd be in 3rd. Maybe I should make that my goal for tonight. Take one of those. Win one of those. Wait, what's the deal here? For... Oh, Queen A8's made on the spot. Okay. Can't fault me for missing that some turns ago. Do we just win the Queen? Oh, come on. I want Knight Takes Bishop to be better somehow. Just somehow do poetic justice to the whole thing. Okay. Sometimes the crude moves are the best. Check. Does not win on the spot. Okay. I guess that works. Check. And now what? That's fancy. Okay, I forget if I've skewered or been skewered in that fashion in a real game. But it hurts just a little bit. Just enough that I remember how to execute that. Does this trap a queen? This traps a queen. Does this win a king? This wins. Oh, just a queen. I don't see the mate here. Okay. It's a mate where you don't have to give check every move. Okay, just go back and mate like so. Oh, check. Get the isolate the king. All right, and then we expose the H file. Easy peasy. Free bishop. Free bishop. Free bishop. Not a free bishop, but still winning. Rook H1's actually superior, because the king doesn't get to run away. Okay, fair enough. I've executed that sort of checkmate before. Oh, take an H5. Mate. Check, check, check. It's a mate in 5. This wins the rook. This traps the king. This wins an exchange. And we're ready for level 55. Oh, did I go quiet? I don't know. I think I'm still here. It's probably just you then. Which, somebody could do the convenience of letting you know it's just you. But here we go. Level 55. The level to end all levels. Maybe. At least at one point it was. Holy moly, what a messy problem. Okay, whoever crafted these has something of a sense of humor. Okay, does this trap a queen? Nope, but it does win a knight. Oh, I wanted a castle. Game took away my castling. So sad. Oh, Maiden 1 takes precedence over Maiden 2. Oh, I've got another rook. Great. Just ask my bughouse partner to give me more pieces. Some of those are just placed as if we were playing bughouse. Right. So you had to do Bishop B5 there. For reasons you'll read about in various books and such. Wait, what's the deal here? Oh, pin the queen. Just win an exchange. Win lots of material. Surprisingly not mate, but it's okay. Is this mate? Is this mate? Is this mate? Is... No, that's not mate. There we go. I found a mate. Take one of those. Okay, win a rook. Maiden 4 was that? Win exchange or something. At some point I'm losing track of how much material I'm winning, and just keeping track of the fact that I'm winning material. This discovery against the queen is pretty powerful. Alright. Oh, crap. Wait. Knight takes d7 is wrong. I was doing so good. Yeah, I could vary it up with king f7, bishop e8, by the way. So that's the other variation, which is relevant in that position. You know, maybe I should just, like, not talk while I'm playing, and try to find the best move. And just focus really hard on not having fun. Yeah. Or I could do things the fun way, and just blunder left and right, and have the audience laughing both with us and against us. Yeah. Oh, right. Thanks, Bughouse Partner, for getting me that rook. And the knight. And we just mate here. Yeah, that one keeps tripping me up a little bit. No matter. So many forks. Check. 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 mate. Just to get out of the mate there. I guess in this puzzle set, when in doubt, just play Rook F1. Oh, there it is. That was published in a book. That one where you play Queen G3 and then Queen C3. That was in a book. I've seen that before. Alright, so let's refresh this. Let's see, where did it put us with the other people who are in 55th? Ah! I have solved. I'm on level 56. Perhaps undeservedly so, because I've only solved 55 of these. But hey, I'll take it. Third place. Dare I keep going? Do I just blitz it all out? No. I think I need to take a break. So, we'll call it there. That's been a fun session. Expect, say, one more of these, hopefully. At least until they install some new problems. It's good that I solved enough of these before this puzzle. Because this puzzle, you have to play Rook F1. And I think I've missed this every time. So, anyhow. Yeah, thanks for watching. Hope you had fun.